I'll start with the director. I like the tagline, what happens when your own disown you? And today, the headlines have only been about hypocrisy, mob lynching, and this movie just seems timely.
Absolutely, I do agree with you. Every headline today, news in the evening, is only harping on these things, what you just said. And I personally feel, I know this answer is supposed to be the director,
no, sir.
I'm just supporting my director on this cause, that our film is a very timely film, where we offer you the problem, we are showing the problem, but we have no solution. So please do not come into the theatre thinking that we have got a solution for you. Because our film is content based, and it's basically an entertaining film, a courtroom drama. It's not a documentary. It's not a film that is going to bore you with all details of what is happening on the national front. It is something which is, we have taken the cinematic liberty to make it a little more engrossing, so the audiences enjoy the film. To you, sir. Over to you.
But prejudices against a community which is penalized for being who they are, for the way they dress. As I was just reading the statistics, one out of, like, say, 25%, I would say non-Muslims, feel that the other one could be a terrorist, could belong to a certain, has loyalties towards a certain country. So this has been happening. You know, sir, also in Indian cinema, you had movies like Garam Hawa that spoke about partition. The narrative somewhere remains the same, where each time you have to show that I don't have to prove my nationalism to you. So what was the idea that you thought that let me make this movie?
The idea actually is rooted in my growing up years, where I have experienced this unrest, disharmony. It is rooted there, but the story actually took shape over the last few years, some headlines, very disturbing headlines. And thankfully it turned out to be an engaging film, an engaging story, which is a courtroom drama, which takes you through a lot of things that are around you, are about you. And so you engage more, and maybe the film ends up posing a few questions to you.
And Taapsee, your reason for doing the movie also were a little personal, weren't they?
Yeah, because personal, one of them, yes, because I am surrounded by a lot of people in my life right now, especially after moving to Mumbai.
Yeah.
I have enough of trolling. I don't want to change the topic of trolling right now because the film is coming on 3rd August, so let's stick to that. So yeah, Mumbai. So they've been my people who manage my work, the people who manage my life, day-to-day life, they belong to this community, and this beautiful country of ours is as much theirs as ours. And if I start doubting on them, then that means there's something going on wrong in my life, and I am in the biggest situation of risk, and which I don't feel. So I'm like, you know, I should be the one saying that no. You know, I feel at ease. I trust them. They are part of my lives. And it's sad that I have to go out and prove it in this way. I'm not proving it. Let's just say the fact that I want to do my bit as an actor, to be a part of this film, as Sir says, which is the story of our times.
And you, when you approached Mr. Kapoor, you had no other actor in mind but him. And you also were a little fearful. What if he says no? So when he came to you with the story,
I know that whole discussion that we had in his office, you're like, only him and no one else.
Really? Yeah, I wouldn't.
Yeah. Know. Bolte hai, paise aur mang lena. Anyway, I thoroughly enjoyed working in this film. To be very honest, it's a very different character. It gave me an opportunity to look something different. I had that reference point. I showed it to him. He liked it. Then we tried to.
Who was your reference point there?
I don't know, some odd guy. Aapko dikhai thi picture. I had it in my on my photos in my iPhone. And then he liked it, and we tried it out, and it suited, you know, the character. And then things went on. Jab acha hona hota na, to kadi se kadi milti jati hai. Jab nahi acha ho, to you know, kahin na kahin bikhar jati hai. So I personally feel that what we have done in our film, we've tried to make a social comment, and this voice is very important that the world hears. It's not just India hears, but the world hears. मुझे ऐसे लोग कहते हैं, बताया गया है कि सब लोग कहते हैं कि all the terrorists are Muslims.
Mm-hmm.
But then all Muslims are not terrorists. You know, there are terrorists in Assam, they're not Muslims there.
Yeah.
you know, there are so many otherwise people happening all over. They're not only of one community. So we have to, you know, kind of address this problem. You know, the world, no. Okay, after all, we are human beings, and एक इंसान दूसरे इंसान के ही काम आएगा ना आपने भरोसे पे रखना है आपने उनसे प्यार जताना है आई मीन व्हाई दिस एनिमोसिटी व्हाई दिस काइंड ऑफ यू नो आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड एंड ही इज बेस्ट प्रूव्ड इट एंड टेकिंग द सिनेमैटिक लिबर्टी ऑफ डूइंग इट इन अ फैशन दैट इट कीप्स द ऑडियंस एनग्रॉस्ड
And also, as you had said, the narrow-minded minority is the one that speaks the loudest, and it's their voice that is being heard, while the majority does not think like that.
Exactly.
Hmm. Yeah, I mean, it's time. Right now, we're going through a phase where the majority has to talk.
You know, that's why I'm interrupting, but this is the problem that we say trolls, right?
Yeah.
So it's not like sare aisa bol rahe. It's not like that. Problem, people ask me, do you feel bad or do you feel hurt that when you're told? Yes, we are, but not because of what they're saying.
Hmm.
But because of the fact that the majority who has the brain to know what is good and bad, they are not talking.
The majority is also scared to talk.
Yeah, so that is what is hurtful. So hurtful are not those comments that those trolls are making. Trust me, I still keep smiling looking at them.
No, 80% of the comments are fantastic.
Yeah.
But those 20%, they are hurtful, but so be it.
So also this fear factor, because I know often they all come to the film industry and say, why doesn't the industry speak up? Their voice matters. But sometimes there's also a fear to speak up because suddenly, whether it's your film, whether it's your family, everybody seems to be at risk.
No, I, such bolne mein koi guna to nahi hai. You must say what it is all about. Dekhi, maine is pehle bhi kaha hai. कि हमने इस पिक्चर में आपको एक हमारी समस्या बताई है यू नो इट्स अ प्रॉब्लम बट वी हैवंट टोल्ड यू व्हाट द सॉल्यूशन इज हम नहीं बता रहे कि हल क्या है वहाँ तो हमें भी नहीं मालूम हल क्या है बट ये दिस प्रॉब्लम इज पर्सिस्टिंग इन अ सोसाइटी अमंगस्ट अस इट पर्सिस्ट अमंगस्ट अस एंड वी हैव टू हेल्प टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम वन ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स
एंड सो एज अ कॉलीग ऑफ माइन हैड वंस रिटन आई रोट एन आर्टिकल व्हिच सेड दैट ही इज अ मुस्लिम ही सेड आई एम नॉट द प्रॉब्लम The problem is the politics is the problem, is the anti-nationalism is the problem, but how do we solve this problem? And you come from Banaras, and you've shot this movie there. So what was that experience? Because it's the bed of Hinduism. I mean, by land you could be Hindu, by faith you could be Muslim, but your identity at the end of the day is India.
Very well said. Yeah, that's it.
You know, we've shot a lot in Lucknow as well. And Banaras is a perceived Hindu city, but obviously, there's a large Muslim population also there. Honestly, I was never interested in Hindu and Muslim while making this film. I was interested in the prejudices and the perceptions that we breed amongst ourselves. And I was addressing those and I was talking about those. The film is about those. That's the reason why the film manages to steer absolutely clear of anything political. It's only about us. And, you know, like she says in her dialogue, that it's about us and them. The day we, as a country, as the citizens of this country, we can address all of us as us, we'll be doing way better and we'll be asking the right questions. You know, we get divided in these things because they don't want us to ask the right questions. They want us to talk about lynching, they want us to talk about temples, mosques. But the real question is food, poverty,
exactly.
Housing.
Absolutely, and those are the questions that need to be addressed, sadly.
You will never be given as much mind space to, and this is not a recent phenomenon.
True.
This is as long as
For the past 70 years since our independence, after part there was partition, then a whole lot of other issues came up in the middle, and now that you have this neo-nationalism, how do you?
Pooja, I just happened to say this upstairs. You see, like I said, I'm very lucky to be born in this lifetime where we have witnessed Russia and China have eradicated, they've lifted communism and embraced you know, capitalism and democracy. We've seen apartheid being abolished in South Africa, the East and West Berlin Wall falling in
Absolutely.
This lifetime.
True.
You know, North Korea shook hands with the United States. They, if they know there's a problem, they have to sit over the table.
True.
But we have been, we have our independence for 71 years, and so does Pakistan. Why can't we not sit down and solve our problems? 71 साल हो गए और आप इसे समस्या पे समस्या ही बनाए जा रहे हैं वही आप कश्मीर के पीछे ही पड़े हैं वही किसी के यू हैव टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम यू कैन नॉट लिव दिस 2018 देखो जी मेरी जनरेशन के लोग अब तो पाकिस्तान कभी जा भी नहीं पाएंगे आई वुड हैव लक टू हैव सीन वेयर माय माय प्रेडिसेसर्स केम फ्रॉम यू नो बिफोर पेशावर दे केम फ्रॉम अफगानिस्तान एंड एवर आई वुड हैव लव टू बट आई डोंट सी द पॉसिबिलिटी नाउ But at least I hope that my son's or my grandson's generation should have an opportunity. We have to shake hands some way or the other. Life is too short. You never know when one, ek kisi ne bomb phod diya to ye wo puri dunia hi phir chali gayi. So we have to somewhere, you know, draw the line and, you know, shake hands over it.
I think somewhere we are all getting lost in the rhetoric of it and just name calling and also somewhere the media and social media, which is now, you know, the latest platform of hate is...
We should immediately abolish the TRP system of news channels. The day that happens, a lot will change in the world. The TRP of
news
channels.
You're right. Everyone's after sensationalism.
True.
You're just running after sensationalism.
It's all about the headlines.
Yeah.
Headline, you know, that fear that you were talking about, it kind of brings that fear. I'll tell you how, my experience. My father, the day the trailer released, I was traveling back to Scotland in the same evening.
Yeah.
And my father, by the time I landed, I had like some 10 odd messages from him. And he's a man who barely messages me. He was in panic state suddenly. He showed me a screenshot of a video by a particular channel, which the headline was Taapsee Speaks Against Narendra Modi. And he saw the video and he was like, that's strange, she did that. And he saw the video and there was nothing against it. Because we clearly said, we have not spoken about any government in the film.
And then that hashtag happened, talk to a Muslim.
Yeah, so he was so scared. He was like, you know, he sent me a letter, like a message saying, you know, we are very non-political people. Why we should not get into these kind of issues. Please tell them to remove this headline. My father was so scared. I was like, Dad, relax. This is going to happen till 3rd of August or even much more, like if this film travels and everyone embraces it, then even beyond that. Because I'll say something, but the people who have to interpret something wrong will do that anyway. So that's the fear I'm talking about. My parents who have got nothing to do with either politics or films for that matter, fear that, you know, something might happen to me because of this particular headline, which I didn't even say. So that's the fear that guards us from doing and saying a lot of things, those headlines. Those are messing things up for all of us.